자, 3D 캐드 튜터입니다. 이어서 다시 뭐 누워서도 배우는 치수공차 이런 것에 대해서 해보겠습니다. Expansion Fit 확장해서 이게 딱그 끼워 맞춤 하는 거죠. 자, 이제 해석 안 하고 영어로 딱 합니다. In assembling certain classes of work requiring a very tight fit, the inner member is contracted by sub-zero cooling to permit insertion into the outer member, and a tight fit is obtained as the temperature rises and the inner part expands. To obtain the sub-zero temperature, solid carbon dioxide or dry ice has been used. But its temperature of about minus 109 Fahrenheit or minus 78 Celsius below zero will not contract some parts sufficiently to permit insertion in holes or recesses. Greater contraction may be obtained by using high purity liquid nitrogen, which has a temperature of about minus 196 Celsius below zero. During a temperature reduction from 75 Fahrenheit to minus 321 Fahrenheit, which is 220 Celsius difference, the shrinkage per inch of diameter varies from about 0.002 to 0.003 inch for steel, 0.0042 inch for aluminum alloys, 0.0046 inch for magnesium alloys, 0.0033 inch for copper alloys, 0.0023 inch for mono metal, and 0.0017 inch for cast iron not alloyed. The cooling equipment may vary from an insulated bucket to a special automatic unit, depending upon the kind of quantity of work. One type of unit is so arranged that parts are pre-cooled by vapors from the liquid nitrogen before immersion. With another type, cooling is entirely by the vapor method. Shrinkage fit. General practice seems to favor a smaller allowance for shrinkage fit than for forced fit, although in many shops the allowances are practically the same for each, and for some classes of work shrinkage allowances exceed those forced fit. The shrinkage allowance also varies to a great extent with the form and construction of the part that has to be shrunk into place. The thickness or amount of metal around the hole is the most important factor. The way in which the metal is distributed also has an influence on the result. Shrinkage allowances for locomotive driving wheel tires adapted by the American Railway Master Mechanics Association are as follows. 요건 이제 표인데, Center Diameter 인치로 나타낸 거는 요렇게 38, 44, 50, 56, 62, 66 이게 행이고, 다음 행으로는 Allowances 인치로 0.04, 0.047, 0.053, 0.060, 0.066, 0.077, 0.070. 이게 허용 인치가 되겠네요. 위에 말한 거는 중심 다이아미터 그거고 다음 장입니다. Whether parts are to be assembled by forced or shrinkage pitch depends upon conditions. For example, to press a tire over its wheel center without heating would ordinarily be a rather difficult job. On the other hand, pins, etc., are easily and quickly forced into place with a hydraulic press, and there is the additional advantage of knowing the exact pressure required in assembly, whereas there is more or less uncertainty connected with a shrinkage fit, unless the stresses are calculated. Tests to determine the difference in the quality of shrinkage and forced fit show that the resistance of a shrinkage fit to slip pitch for an actual pull was 3.66 times greater than that of a forced fit, and in rotation or torsion, 3.2 times greater. In each comparative test, dimensions and allowances were equal. Allowances for shrinkage pitch. The most important point to consider when calculating shrinkage pitch is the stress in the hub at the bore, which depends chiefly upon the shrinkage allowance. If the allowance is excessive, the elastic limit of the material will be exceeded, and permanent sag will occur, or in extreme conditions. The ultimate strength of the metal will be exceeded and the hub will burst. The intensity of the grip of the feet and the resistance to slip pitch depend mainly upon the thickness of the hub. The greater the thickness, the stronger the grip, and vice versa. Assuming the modulus of elasticity for steel to be30 million or 206.8 times 10^-6 megapascal, and for cast iron 15 million or 103.4 times 10^-6 megapascal. The shrinkage allowance per inch or millimeter of nominal diameter can be determined by the following formula, in which A equal allowance per inch or millimeter of diameter, T equals true tangential tensile strength at inner surface of outer member, megapascal. C equal factor taken from one of the accompanying table 1, table 2, and table 3. For a cast iron hub and steel shaft, A equal metric은 미터는 A equal 25.4 times T 가로 열고 2 더하기 C 가로 닫고 나누기 206.843 곱하기 12 9승 이게 미터로 된 거고 이거는 이거 좀 이렇게 좀 이게 귀에 의지하는 게 뿐만이 아니라 눈으로도 요거 식을 봐야 됩니다. 이런 거는 표랑 이런 거는 100% 읽지는 않더라도 이게 귀와 눈을 조화를 시키는 게 편하죠. When both 다음 장입니다. When both hub and shaft are of steel. 미터 같은 경우에는 여기 구독자가 이제 미터 하잖아요. 이게 책에서는 미국 그 임페리얼이랑 그 국제 표준 미터 다 나오는데 미터만 이게 읽어드리면 미터는 A는 25.4 곱하기 T 가로 열고 1 더하기 C 가로 닫고 이제 전체 나누기 206.843 곱하기 10의 구순. If the shaft is solid, the factor C is taken from table 1. If it is hollow and the hub is of steel, factor C is taken from table 2. If it is hollow and the hub is of cast iron, the factor is taken from table 3. Table 1. Factors for calculating shrinkage fit allowances for steel shafts and steel or cast iron hubs. 자, 이게 표 보면 이게 얼마나 이게 이거 책 이거 해가지고 이게 실험 결과예요, 이거. 다 이게 고생해가지고 뭐 사이언티픽 엔지니어링 다 테스트 이거 다 해가지고 이렇게 한 건데 이거 표를 이렇게 딱 보시면 D1 분의 D2 뭐 이렇게 스틸 허브 캐스트 아이런 허브 레이시오 오브 다이미러 이게 나와 있습니다. 읽으시면 되고요. 보시면 되고요. 표는 Example 1. A steel crank web 375mm outside diameter is to be shrunk on a 250mm solid steel shaft. Required is the allowance per millimeter of shaft diameter to produce a maximum tensile stress in a crank of 170 megapascal, assuming the stresses in the crank to be equivalent to those in a ring of the diameter given. The ratio of the external to the internal diameters equals 375 divided by 250 equals 1.5. T equals 170 megapascal. From table 1, C equals 0.227. Substituting in formula 2B, formula A equals 25.4 곱하기 170 곱하기 가로 열고 1 더하기 0.227 가로 닫고 여기서 이제 전체 나누기 206843은 0.026mm가 되겠습니다. 다음 장. Example 2. 책에서 예제도 나오네요. 두 번째 예제. Find the allowance per millimeter of diameter for a 250mm shaft having a 125mm axial through hole, other conditions being the same as example 1. The ratio of external to internal diameters of the hub equals 375 divided by 250 equals 1.5 as before, and the ratio of external to internal diameters of the shaft equals 250 divided by 125 equal 2. From table 2, we find that factor C equals 0.455, T equals 170 megapascal. Substituting these values in formula 2B. A equals 25.4 times 170 bracket 1 plus 0.455 bracket over 206843 equals 0.030 millimeter. The allowance is increased as compared with example 1 because the hollow shaft is more compressible. Example 3. If the crank web in example 1 is of cast iron and 28 megapascal is the maximum tensile stress in the hub, what is the allowance per millimeter of diameter? D2 over D1 equals 1.5, T equals 28. In table 1, we find that C equals 0.234. Substituting in formula 2B for cast iron hubs, A equals 0.0076 millimeter, which, owing to the lower tensile strength of cast iron, is about one-third the shrinkage allowance in example 1, although the stress is two-thirds of the elastic limit. 자, 이건 표예요. Table 2, factors for calculating shrinkage fit allowances for hollow steel shafts and steel hubs. 이렇게 쫙 나와 있네요. Table 3, factors for calculating shrinkage fit allowances for hollow steel shafts and cast iron hubs. 자, 시청각 자료로 이렇게 딱 누워서도 기아 공창 뭐 이런 거 다 하는데, GDNT 이런 거 딱 이거 하면 이제 전문가 되는 겁니다. 이게 전문가 서적을 좀 보고 전문가 이게 하는데 전문가 되는 거죠. 이게 그게 뭐냐, 이게 실험 결과까지 에다가 이론까지 다 이게 어, 조화가 이루어진 거니까요. 네, 다음에 이제 기대해 주시고 시청해 주셔서 감사합니다.